It's our lucky day, B. Let's go find a game of cards.
These Glyphod roots, they're everywhere.
Well, we are underground.
Then I guess we have some clearing up to do.
And me without my gardening shears.
Like, killing the roots, right? It doesn't actually reduce the amount of blood that Urizen gets, because they still have enough to make the Clyphoff fruit. So basically, a lot of what they do in the story early on is just pointless until they find out about the Devil Sword Sparda. I don't know. Just interesting when you think about it.
Now to find an exit.
God, I hate this level. Look at it getting juggled. Alrighty then.
Can't move forward without breaking the leaves.
Here.
Put infinity in the palm of your...
That'll make the boss fight easier for when we do it as Nero. Oh, a barrel here. I wonder what that's supposed to be. Oh, that actually does damage good. They can dive into it. How Nightmare can kill enemies? Because the reason why Griffin and Shadow can't kill enemies is because they're just nightmares, right? A nightmare can hurt you, but it can't kill you. But then the Nightmare can kill you? Like, huh? I don't know. I guess he's just like that powerful. Come on, V could have totally soloed the heroes if he used Nightmare. The problem is that, you know, obviously Nightmare can only last a few seconds. I don't know, if he just fought with Nero... Oh fuck. Did that teleport attack really go? Alright.
Come on! Come on.
Come on.
At your pleasure.
This ship is awfully big.
Those red orbs, so I'm not gonna waste my time. Big Impusa. The fucking team killer. Last bit of health bar is bigger than the rest of the health bar. Heal orbs. Get them. Where's the leg? I actually didn't see it. Formed of joy and birth.
This way, I guess.
Go.
No, it's the one that's already dead. How did that not damage me? These things are so annoying, like they have a billion million health, look at this shit. Why is there just like random orbs of Devil Trigger lying around? Like, I get the red orbs because there's a, like, it's like demon blood or something. This boss is also easier as V than as Vergil. Just because you can keep your distance.
Malthus, of course, more trouble. Not sure about that one though. Never seen it before.
This is where the story actually starts to get going. Because before this, they're just killing Clifop Roots for no reason.
You know where it is. He told me to leave it be. But I'm afraid it still concerns me. As long as there is a blood descendant of Sparda, I cannot take any chances. Do you understand? Find it and destroy it! Only then will his reign be truly realized.
Imagine if Malthus just like, you know, listened to Urizen about the Devil Sword Sparda. Urizen would have just like won.
I see. I know what you are. Don't worry. I'll be gentle.
And that's a lot funnier on your second playthrough. Because obviously, you know, Trish is in there and
an angel that presided on my birth is a little creature fond of joy. Your love without the help of anything is worth.
Yeah.
It's rising. Feels immense.
It's not the time for poetry!
Come on. There's a will, there's a way. Now let's go.
Oh. Shadow died. Now, if you're pro, you can parry it. Parry Cavalier Angelo with the Beast Cane, but like, yeah, I just tried it and I'm not that good. Can't actually do that, right? Got hit so many times there.
Yeah. wisdom no clock can measure. Die.
They only find Dante because they overhear Malthus.
What will you do if you find it? You gotta be strong in mind and body to wield the Sparda, and you, sir, are not. Hate to break it to you, but the Sparda will just be too much for you.
For me, yes. But what if the boy, Nero? Let's go. Once we are near the Sparda, even I should be able to sense its presence.
They really blueball you with Nero with the Devil Sword Sparda idea, and then you never actually, you know, do it. Alright, another S rank in the bag. Well, we all know Vergil likes monster energy, so. Yeah. Alright, see you next episode.